In this video, I am going to explain about fundamental theorem of arithmetic. It can be seen in your NCERT class 10 real number chapter 1 portion. So let's go through it. State fundamental theorem of arithmetic. Every composite number can be expressed or factorized as a product of primes, and this factorization is unique apart from the order in which the prime factor occur. Prime number means it can be factorized by his number and also by one only. Any natural number can be written as the product of its prime factors. Let's see with an example. First question. Express 32760 as the product of its prime factors. As I have already told you, any natural number can be written as the product of its prime factor. How can you find out prime factor for this number 32760? First, 32760, obviously it can be divisible by 2. 32 by 2, which is 16, 760, 7 means 3 2s are 6, 16, which is 8, 0. Again, it is divisible by 2. You can divide it and find out the divisible number. 8, 1, 9, 0. Again, it is divisible by 2. Now it is divisible by 3. It is also divisible by 3. This 455 is not divisible by 3, so we can go for 5. 91 is divisible by 7. 13 into 7 is 91. So 32760 can be expressed from in this manner: 13 into 7 into 5 into 3 square into 2 cube. 13 into 7 into 5 into 3 square into 2 cube. This is the prime factor for this number 32760. Now you can see another two questions. Your second question is 3825. Express this number as the product of its prime factor. For that, you have to divide and find out the prime factors for this number. 3825, it is clearly divisible by 5. 765, it is again divisible by 5, which is 153. It is divisible by 3. 51, it is again divisible by 3, 7. So 3825 can be expressed as 5 square into 3 square into 17. A small number. Your third question is 156. 156. It is divisible by 2, which is 78. 78 by 2 is 39. 39 is divisible by 3, which is equal to 13. So 2 square into 3 into 13. Your next question is Find LCM and HCF of the following integers by applying prime factorization method. Question number 1, 12, 15, 21. You have to find out LCM and HCF of the integers by applying prime factorization method. First, you have to express 12 in terms of its prime factors. 12 is 2 square into 3. Then 15. 15, it is clear that 3 into 5 is 15. Then 21. 21, it is also clear that 7 into 3 is 21. So, what is your LCM? LCM means least common multiple. LCM means it is the product of the greatest power of each prime factor involved in the numbers. So you have to take the product of the greatest power of each prime factor. Here for 12 you can take 2 square. 3 occurs only once in every integer. So you can write 3. Then 5 also occurs once. So you can write 5. 7 also occurs once. So your LCM is 2 square into 3 into 5 into 7. Then what about your HCF? HCF means highest common factor. It is the product of smallest factor of prime factor involved in the numbers. So you can take only the common factor for considering HCF. What is the common factor in these integers? You can only find 3 in this integer as per common. So HCF is equal to 3. Don't get confused. LCM means least common multiple. HCF means highest common factor. So here you can take only common number from the integers. Here you can take the greatest power from all the integer numbers. So your next question is, 3 bells toll at intervals of 9, 12, 15 minutes respectively. If they start tolling together, after what time will they next toll together? These type of questions you can expect for your board exam. Here it is asked toll together. Together means all together. That means here you have to take LCM, not HCF. So LCM of 9, 12 and 15 you have to take. So 9, you know that 3 into 3 prime factorization method. 12, we have already found it that 2 square into 3. For 15, it is 5 into 3. So your LCM, you have to take it full. So you can take it 3 square into 2 square into 5, because LCM is the greatest power of each prime factor involved in the numbers. 3 square is 9, 9 into 4 into 5, 4 into 5, 20, 20 into 9, it is 180 minutes. Next question, 144 cartons of Coke cans and 90 cartons of Pepsi cans are to be stacked in a canteen. If each stack is of the same height and if it contains equal cartons of the same drink, what would be the greatest number of cartons each stock should have? Here it is asked the greatest number of cartons, not each carton number or lowest number of cartons. Here it is asked the greatest number of cartons. So what you have to find, LCM or HCF? Here you have to find HCF of 144 and 90. So HCF of 144 and 90. So 144 by 2, which is 72, again by 2, which is 36, again by 2, which is 18, again by 2, which is 9, then 3, 3. So 144 can be expressed as 2 raised to 4 into 3 square. Then for 90, 90 by prime factorization, first divisible by 2, 45, then it is again divisible by 3, which is 15, then it is divisible by 3, which is 5. So 2 into 3 square into 5. So HCF is equal to, HCF means product of the smallest factor of a prime factor involved in the numbers. Here 2 only present here once. So you can take only 2 here. 3 square present in 2 integers. So you can take 3 square. So 2 into 3 square. 3 square which is 9. 9 into 2 which is 18. Hope you have understood this video. Thank you.